Hey guys, it's the Test Lead, and today I'm walking you through a day in the life of remote work working from Hawaii, but for a New York City-based tech company. The first thing you realize is the time difference. New York City is 6 hours ahead of Hawaii. So even though working remotely, I must attend all the meetings based off of the Eastern Standard Time Zone. My role for my team is lead SDET, or software developer engineering test, or simply automation tester, which I'll get to more later. Whenever I first sign on, whether it's at home or remotely, I check the nightly automation runs. The nightly automation, they set up test cases that runs automatically every night that makes sure that our APIs and UI and different components of our project are working correctly. Because I'm in charge of automation, my job is to show that if it's working, cool, perfect. But if something is not working and failed a test, I had to figure out why and see if it's a real problem or see if something is wrong in my actual automation test. So right now I'm writing down all the failures and problems for the nightly automation test. Next, we have the daily stand-up meeting. This is a very short, quick status update meeting that happens every morning to start the day. Everybody from the team attends this meeting, including the team lead, product owner, developers, automation testers, and manual testers. In this meeting, we give status updates of what we accomplished yesterday, what we plan to do today, and we get any new tasks or problems for the current day. So because I haven't been here in a while, it's my first day back, it's gonna be an easy day for me. Especially because this is the end of a sprint. Sprints are part of Agile methodology, which has 2 week cycles. Every 2 weeks we focus on a different iteration of a project. Once we fix it, we start another 2 week cycle. And we have continuous integration and continuous development. For my current team, we have 4 developers, 1 manual tester, and then me, 1 automation tester. As mentioned previously, I'm the lead automation person. So the developers also write automation, but in order for them to get approved and checked, it must go through me for a code review, which I'll get to later on. My daily meeting is done. I'm making my coffee, so you have some time to talk. As mentioned previously, my team has 4 regular developers, me as an automation tester, and then 1 manual tester. We also have a team lead, which oversees the project, as well as a product owner, which introduces the new features and actions for each sprint cycle. We have test plan meetings, which include the developer working on a certain feature or action, the automation tester, and manual tester. In these meetings, we outline what test coverage will be, what will be manually tested, what will be automation tested. That way, developers know in advance what to code for. Normally, everything is manually tested at least once to make sure it works, because manual testing is faster. For automation, I have to do a whole setup. So automation is good for regression testing or redundant testing. But the initial test and test plan is done by the manual tester. Once they test it once, verify it works, I then automate that process. That way, for regression testing, or test it to make sure that it works in future releases and sprints, we can automate it so we hit a button and runs the test automatically. Now, let's discuss my job task for today that were given to me in our daily meeting earlier on. It's a Friday, it's the end of the sprint, so honestly speaking, it's a pretty light day. First, I must finish analyzing the failing test for the nightly automation. Then, I must do code reviews for the developers who wrote automation this sprint. I will dive deeper into this later on and explain what that means. And last but not least, I must update this mode functionality for tests that are no longer relevant because of changes in this sprint. Now, I am having a meeting with my team lead. We're discussing everything that I missed while I was on vacation. I'm also catching up with what I did on vacation. My team lead's nice and actually cares about me. Love it. We are also discussing where we're at with certain things and making sure that our ideas are aligning for ending this sprint and going into the next sprint. After the meeting, I realized I forgot my charger for my laptop in my car. So I get it. You see this beautiful dark view because it's very early in the morning still. Got my charger and now it's back to work. Me personally, when I have my tasks for the day, I like to time box my tasks saying, okay, this I'll spend an hour on. This I'll spend 2 hours on. That way, one task isn't just taking over my whole day. So now it's 6:10 here in Hawaii. Get my second and a half cup of coffee, especially because I'm on vacation, I don't drink coffee at all. So right now, this is definitely waking me up. I now have a team meeting to discuss our plans for the next sprint cycle. We're gonna see what different tasks and items we plan to take in for the next cycle and who they might get assigned to. That way, once the sprint starts, we're all on the same page and hit the ground running. It's now 8 a.m. here in Hawaii. I have a webinar for a boot camp that I'm an instructor for.
Hello, can everybody see and hear me? Perfect, everybody in the chat. Everybody in the chat, thumbs up. Can you hear me? Perfect. Okay, great. So first off, my name is Justin Bailey. I am based out of New York, but right now I'm in Hawaii. So, see my background.
And as you can see, someone from the webinar actually recognized me as the test lead. Usually it happens once or twice every webinar or info session, but it's pretty cool. So as you've noticed, I'm part of a boot camp which has live instructors, but I also offer a course on my website. Both have their pros and cons. The boot camp, as I said, has live instructors. The course has all pre-recorded lessons. So whatever fits you and your budget and your needs, you can apply for both of them. The link for each one will be in the description box below. So now it's 10 a.m. all my stuff is done for the day, it's time to hit the gym. So just to reinforce this, me personally, I have my experience, I have my role at my current company, my situation is my situation. I get my task for the day, I complete my task, whether it takes me 5 hours or 10 hours, that's up to me. As long as my tasks get done, I attend all my meetings, the rest of my time for my day is up to me. So whether I spend it doing webinars or sitting on a couch, that's my luxury. Your situation may be different, but back to the video. All my stuff is done, hit the gym, everything's cool, grab some food, take a nap for about an hour, recharge. That way I can start the second part of my day. So now I'm gonna give you a quick tour around my resort. As you can see, it has a bunch of pools, it has a beach, it has some water slides. It's very nice. And you also can see why I didn't work every day on vacation. Part of working hard is you work hard to enjoy something later on, delayed gratification. But if I'm working hard, never get to enjoy anything, then what's the point? So the first half of my vacation was just enjoying it. Now today's my first day back of actually working. Now all the water stuff is finished, it's time to explore. First, I heard about Chinatown in Hawaii. I heard it has a lot of good food, a lot of good places to see. So let's go. I went there, looked around. Certain blocks were beautiful, and then the next block or next street would be terrible. It would be all abandoned places. So personally, because I had a rental car, I didn't feel safe leaving my rental car in Chinatown for too long. So I stayed there for maybe like 15, 20 minutes. I was like, yeah, let's go down to Waikiki and enjoy that. So Waikiki is very nice, a lot of bright lights, has a strip of high-end stores and regular stores, just like Hollywood in California, if you've ever been there. Very nice experience. So I get some dinner, I get some Panda Express, and some donuts from Penny's. These donuts were raved about, so I said, okay, I'll give it a try. And they didn't let me down. They were wonderful, nice, soft, and doughy, perfect. And then, to end the night, one of the hotels in Waikiki has a fireworks show every Friday night. So I went there, enjoyed it, perfect vacation. If you got any value from this video at all, please like, share, and subscribe. And most importantly, don't forget to learn something new today.
Can you help me?